Hi Virgo, in today's reading we'll be looking at who is coming towards you, July, August 2022. It's Virgo singles. I actually want to see your overall energy here for the next few months. What is Virgo's energy? We'll start with that. World, we like that. Eight of Pentacles, wow, work success, definitely. Very hard working period, but yet you're also seeing the fruits of your labor here. You'll be rewarded for the work you've putting in into some project, some, I don't know what you're doing, but we have the Saturn world and Eight of Pentacles come through here. This is a successful completion of a cycle, and it has to do with your 10th house, reputation, career, but financial improvement here for sure. Wow, I love it for you. It's a really good start to the reading. Hierophant, yeah, you knowing your worth here. See, second house with Taurus also talks about self-worth, as well as assets and accumulating wealth, right? So it's almost like they're saying the second house. The second house is where you'll see a lot of improvement. Some of you may be purchasing property, a home. Seven of Wands. Yeah, it's like you've been, you've been really working hard. We have Two of Pentacles, juggling two jobs. Sometimes can talk about multiple streams of income, but it's also a card of balance, right? Work, home, love, homework, that sort of thing. So I do see you getting more organized, prioritizing. Seven of Wands, we have all these sticks coming at this one person, but they're on top, right? Sometimes there can be a fear of losing what we have here with the Seven of Wands, and they're saying there's nothing you have to worry about. This has a lot to do, I feel like, with your work. Who is coming towards Virgo singles in their love life? July, August. Page of Cups, Six of Cups. Well, there is a very sweet love offer. It is a page, it's something small. Some of you, this offer is coming from a distance. We have King of Wands. He's pointing at the globe. Some of you, Six of Cups can sometimes talk about reunions. That really depends. But it was, I feel like love at a distance here for you. Three of Wands. Who is coming towards Virgo singles in love? We'll get this person's intentions, what they want, what they... Justice. King of Swords can be a Libra specifically, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. This energy, very chill, laid back. This person's not about drama. They are wanting that. They're wanting to give to you, but they're all about fairness here. That's very important. Some of them may have Venus and Libra in their natal chart. We have Justice, Six of Pentacles. It's like taking baby steps towards another. Really trying to feel out the situation, right? I don't want to be taken advantage of. I'm going to give a little bit and see how Virgo responds. So yeah, doing things in moderation and not the most open initially. It's small offers. This King of Swords is usually not one that likes to be vulnerable. They don't wear their heart on their sleeve. But there is a romantic expression coming from this person. Justice can also talk about integrity. Some of you, if this is a past person, this combination can also talk about an apology. Someone wanting to communicate and make things right. Some of you, you may be connecting with someone who's working in the legal field. Something to do with tax, lawyers, police, that is also coming through. Very few of you, this person can be a divorcee and they may have a child. Why is Justice here? Let's get clarity on that. Three of Wands. Knight of Cups, yeah. With time and patience, this person will be more vulnerable with you. Four of Pentacles, Knight of Cups. But they need time to sort of assess you and get to know you better. What action will this person be taking towards Virgo singles? Hangman. What action will this person be taking towards Virgo singles? Two of Wands. Well, patience is required. I mentioned that with Hangman. it's slow and steady progress, but what action? They'll be very understanding here, and I feel like you will have to make plans. So what action? They'll be wanting to make plans here, magician, to see you. Some of you, it can be long distance, but a lot of you, I saw magician, which is our community short distance travel. So they can be in your vicinity here, not too far. The only problem with this, the only problem, I was about to say, my cards fell on the ground. The only problem that some of you may have is this person's slow approach. They move at a turtle's pace. Some of you may appreciate that because you are earth sign. Others of you may be a little bit impatient. King of Cups. But this person has a lot of love. It'll be true love. Seven of Cups. Yeah, someone here is moving away from a long-term commitment or investment here, whatever that was. Can even be a family situation, and they're ready to create something new here. Why is Two of Wands? There's a strong, it's like a soulmate connection here that's coming in. Clarify Two of Wands. And my hair is stuck here. Yeah, not the most vulnerable. The way you enter this person's life is very unexpectedly, is the best way to put it. And it, I don't think this person's expecting it. A message comes in out of the blue. If you guys are single here, I feel you're happily single. There's not much worries, or that is the energy that you're moving into. Very content. This person, they may even have some sort of psychic abilities. I don't know what they do. They may be very spiritual themselves. They have a very calm, peaceful aura. They may even be like a yoga teacher or something, or in the healing field. They'll be relying on their intuition to sort of maneuver through the situation with you, how to approach you. They're emotionally available. It takes them time. They're a little bit reserved. That is what I'm getting. But this will be a beautiful match. The Queen of Cups was wanting to flip through. A strong emotional connection and an equal give and take. Six of Pentacles. Fairness here. So I don't see one of you, right? It's paired next to Magician. Maybe in past relationships, you were dealing with people that weren't very communicative. You never knew where you stood with them. Not with this person. They will be saying it like it is. It may take them a little bit time to trust you, but once they do, they will be open and honest with you. And I see a great back and forth. I see great conversation here, really. And it's not that you will be doing all the talking, or you are the one who's always initiating. There will be a good balance here. I love that. What is this person's intentions towards Virgo singles? The Lovers. What is this person's intentions towards Virgo singles? Ace of Pentacles. A relationship. It's a seed. Keep that in mind. Ace of Pentacles is always potential, right? Here's an opportunity. Now it's up to the both of you. We always have free will, right? Make what you want out of it. But what they are telling us here is that this person doesn't have bad intentions towards you. There's a strong magnetic attraction here is what I'm feeling. Mostly getting a strong emotional attraction, but there is physical here as well with the Lovers. And they do want to offer you a gift, something stable. Clarify the Lovers for this person's intentions. Yeah, Page of Pentacles. Let's be friends. Let's get to know each other. They're very slow moving, which I mentioned, but I see a lot of back and forth communication. Clarify Ace of Pentacles. Page Four of Wands, Nine of Cups. They'll be putting you on a pedestal, is what I'm getting. Do you see how he's raising the pentacle above his head, like studying a situation? But again, with patience, slowly and steadily, you will work your way up here to something solid. I was seeing the Four of Wands. That can be a moving in together card. What is the potential outcome here between Virgo and this person coming towards them? What is the potential outcome? Winter may be very significant here for this connection or your love life in general. What is the potential outcome? I hate when the cards clump together. Don't like it. There you go. Magician. I love that. What is the potential outcome? Ten of Wands. Seven of Swords. Okay. Clarify the Seven of Swords. Okay, sorry, I had to get a lot of cards because two people ended up showing up here in your outcome. You'll have a choice. I see you completing a cycle, you focusing more on your stability, whatever that means to you. Maybe taking better care of your health. If you have children, that will be your focus. But it's just the day-to-day, being mindful, living your life, right? Getting more organized and just a very hardworking person is how you're coming through. And you're manifesting a new cycle, a new start when it comes to your love life. But Fool and Sun literally to me talk about a happier cycle, right? And some of you, there is a tendency here to look back at the past, or there may be reminders from time to time. That individual, that was a soulmate connection. It was teaching you lessons here. But the energy surrounding that card, Three of Swords, Four of Swords, Five of Pentacles, it's someone who's very slow to offer you anything, but it's also someone who's very stubborn and hasn't changed their ways. The romantic connection remains, right? It's a soulmate, and they do miss you with the Five of Cups. There's memories here. But I would recommend not revisiting the past if your past does knock at your door. I don't think that will end well, Virgo. But in terms of your new cycle, I was asking who you're likely to choose, and it's the King of Swords, that Libra energy that I was picking up on here. I see you saying no to the past because we had the Six of Wands and Judgment in reverse. So it's a situation that you felt failed in the past. I don't see you wanting to revisit that. There's someone else you'll be getting to know with the King of Swords, Eight of Wands. Eight of Wands is Mercury in Sagittarius. A lot of back and forth communication. Sometimes can talk about travel and distance, right? Can be online, social media. A variety of ways with, you know, through which you can meet. But I see equals here. And someone who's honest, truthful, someone with integrity, someone who doesn't want to lead you astray. So that is the person I see you picking, Virgo. Oh, that card, deck. This is the deck I want. I felt like I had two lovers for you in your last singles reading. And I feel I'm picking up on your past here. Don't you love it? Past person always wants to come up in all your readings. Who is coming towards Virgo singles in love? Fastlane. Yeah, soulmate. Some of you, your past person was a soulmate, but it was a love-hate dynamic. The way this person comes in with Fastlane, it's out of nowhere. Eight of Wands, right? It's fast movement forward. You're not expecting it. Who is coming towards Virgo singles? Pregnancy. Ooh. And guess what? Online connection I was trying to peek through. But don't be afraid. If you are wanting to get pregnant, this is a positive omen. But if you're not, then always be careful, right? We have a new love is entering your life, whom you may have a child with or work on a new project together. So some of you may be wanting a family with this individual. But pregnancy can also just talk about a new cycle, a new start, right? A lot of you, this is a new love. You don't know this person that's coming in. Oh, it fell. On guard. I'm not surprised this card comes through, Virgo, because it reminds me of justice. And I was telling you, this person's a little bit reserved. We have guards will be up in this relationship. It's okay to be cautious and take it slow, but make an effort to trust a little more. I'm seeing strong trust issues on this person's side. But, woo. I don't know if I should take that. I'm not going to. We have this, we had the score. I think this person will be wanting to pursue you. It's for a lot of you, but past life, I can definitely feel that with that strong Pisces 12th house energy, right? There's a sense of familiarity. If you believe in past life connections, I definitely see that here. But just feeling like you've known this person, there's something here that's very familiar. We have slow and steady. Slow and steady wins the race. Progress may be slow, but it will turn out to be beneficial than to make hasty decisions. There can be. With fast lane and slow and steady, to some of you, you know, one of you may be moving at a slower pace than the other would like, but they're telling you to be more cautious here and take things slow, build a friendship. Yeah, a new dawn. It's new love. A new love and a new dawn, right? The worst is behind you. Seven of Swords. Literally, do you see how the Ten of... I love this. Do you see how the Ten of Wands, the figure, has his back turned to the Seven of Swords? I don't think you're interested. You're diverting your attention to your work and home. Yourself. You will be your focus, right? With the Queen of Pentacles. Perhaps some of you were... giving this person a lot of your energy, right? Letting this person live in your head, rent-free. That is sort of the vibe. And commitment. You may get engaged or fully dedicate yourself to something that will be long-lasting. I see long-lasting success here in terms of your career, but also relationships. Yeah, whoever this soulmate was, we have frenemies here. So perhaps didn't have your best interests at heart, but you learned to establish better healthy boundaries, and you're looking for commitment, you're manifesting commitment, and that is what is coming in. The worst is behind you. Exciting new experiences are on the horizon. I love this for you, Virgo. I really do. All is well. Don't you love that? You're on the right track. Keep listening to your intuition. Third eye. I'm seeing some spiritual gifts here. So utilize them. We have everything is unfolding exactly as it should be. Find peace and wisdom by accepting what is. So you're on the right track, even if it feels like an uphill climb. You're doing well. Keep pushing forward. And there will be a breakthrough here, really, is what I'm getting. Love and career. Didn't I say keep pushing forward? It's an uphill climb. Look at that, overcoming challenges. You're on the right path, even though it may feel, oh my goodness, it's a word for word what I just said. You're on the right path, even though it may feel like an uphill climb at times. Deal with any obstacles as they pave the way to your success. That's crazy. It's not all smooth sailing here, Virgo, right? They're reminding you, but you're still on the right path. We have breaking down. Yeah. Upheaval is shaking the foundation of your security. Question your thoughts, beliefs, and actions. Are they naive or blinding you? Necessary imminent change. I'm not sure what this is about. a lot of you has to do with your love life, because it's a love reading. So it can be that you were turning a blind eye to whatever this deception in and out energy was. And it's almost like it's similar imagery to the tower, right, in traditional tarot. So I do see things breaking down so you can build anew with the new dawn, right? So there will be people, places, things, thought patterns that you're leaving behind so you can build anew. But this new cycle will be more aligned with who you're becoming, because I almost feel like you're not who you were here in the past, right? Perhaps you were naive, but look, yeah, increase in finances and spirit guides. So they are trying to contact you and they are speaking to you via your intuition here as well. Yeah, you've grown here. We have mature woman and increase in finances. Some of you are really stepping up here, the latter. Don't pay attention to gender, right? That doesn't matter. I always say that. We have expect an increase in finances related to your own efforts. Eight of Pentacles. It could be a raise, promotion, or approval for a loan or grant. You've earned it. You deserve this success. It's like Saturn is rewarding you, really, is what I'm getting here, Virgo. Let's end with these astrology cards. See if they want to tell us anything else. Venus. Saturn. Some of you may have Venus, Saturn, and we have Capricorn. I was telling you, Saturn is rewarding you. This is a difficult placement. Yeah, some of you, if you've had your heads in the clouds and, you know, haven't been as mindful, maybe daydreaming, I don't know what you've been doing. Maybe seeing things with rose-colored glasses. I see you grounding your energy with Capricorn, coming back to Earth here. But Venus and Saturn, whether trine, conjunct, whatever, is normally a difficult aspect. And it is telling me that some of you have struggled here with your love life. It can be that you've been single for your whole life, or you attract short-term partnerships, superficial relationships, and what you're attracting here with Venus Saturn is a long-term romantic partner, someone that will stick to you like glue is what I'm getting. They'll be very loyal, dedicated, and I think they have similar values here to you, so you'll both be on the same page. But again, with Venus Saturn, it's highlighting over and over to me that it will be slow and steady progress, and that will be beneficial for the both of you. But I see that if you build a friendship, right, you'll be starting off from a solid foundation. It's beautiful, because whatever your past was, that crumbled because there wasn't that foundation laid, right? Maybe that was the fast lane where things really, you know, it could have been one of those whirlwind romances, right? Things really got off the ground, but then they burned just as fast. Burned down just as fast with breaking down. So that could have been eye-opening for you, or there were some valuable lessons you were learning through that connection. But yeah, Saturn is lessons paired with Venus. There are some lessons you've been learning through your love life, but they're saying congratulations, you've completed that cycle and you're ready for the next step here in life. And that involves a lot of success, long-term success, long-term commitment. That is what I have for you, Virgo. Take care of yourself, and I will see you next week. Bye.